this moment on. You for me, dear, only two for tea, dear, from this moment on, from this happy day.
Welcome to Senior Moments. I'm Bonnie D. Graham.
And I'm Ruth Betty. I'm Bonnie's mom. Ruth. I was originally playing Ruth Dalgo, but I got very fancy over the past few shows, and I figured I'd be extra fancy. So I am Ruth Betty.
I love it. Hi, Mom. How are you?
Fine.
How are you? How was your summer?
It was wonderful.
We took time off. We haven't been in the studio in a couple months.
I know. I felt that you needed the rest.
Wait a minute. I'm the junior senior. You're the senior senior. I needed a rest.
Well, you were looking tired.
Thank you. Okay. I appreciate it very much. As we used to
that.
Say in the family, I appreciate it. We used to say that. The rabbi, somebody used to say, I appreciate it. Remember?
I don't remember.
You'll think of it later.
Right.
Well, Senior Moments is a show about appreciating and appreciating, however you say it in your family, our seniors, our most precious resource. And we try to bring you interesting guests on topics of interest, things that I don't know enough about. Sometimes Ruth knows a little about it.
A little.
Mm-hmm. And we try to share with you our guest knowledge so you can be a little smarter about some important things. And today we're going to talk about the updates in elder law, especially in New York State, specifically power of attorney. So I'm going to do the boarding house reach now. Danny, we're going to go to a big wide three shot here, and I'm going to welcome Beth Polner Abrams, Esquire. Hi, Beth.
Hi, Beth. There we go.
Hi, Ruth.
Hi, dear.
Now, those of you who find Beth looking very familiar, she is because she was on the show with us about a year ago.
That's correct.
Just about a year.
Nice to be back.
Thank you. Beth is a veteran of the TV wars, and I'm going to read a little bit about Beth. Danny, we can just look at Beth while I'm doing this because we don't want, there you go. Beth Polner Abrams, for over 25 years, has provided quality legal representation to seniors and the disabled, as well as customized estate planning to meet the personal needs of families, their children, and other loved ones. Her broad legal background includes federal and state litigation and appeals in the New York State Appellate Division and Court of Appeals. I'm going to skip down to the part we're interested in. She's a member of the New York State, the Nassau, and Suffolk County Bar Associations. Beth has lectured for the New York State Bar, and she's a member of the National Academy of Elder Law Attorneys. She's a past chair and current member of the Senior Umbrella Network of Nassau, which I know, Beth, because I work with some people in the Sun. It's an association of business professionals and advocates involved with seniors, and she's past chair of the Nassau County Bar Association Elder Law Social Services and Health Advocacy Committee. And her website is bpaelderlaw.com. So now we know all about you. Beth, what's going on with the changes as of September 1st?
Yes.
In power of attorney. And
yes.
When you dial it back, I need to have a completely 101 description of what is power of attorney, because I hate to tell you, I'm not sure.
Okay, sure. Well, power of attorney is the opportunity for anyone, it's not just seniors, really everyone should have one, the opportunity to designate in writing someone who's going to be able to take care of financial affairs for you. And it could be as simple as, I'm going on a world cruise, I'll be back in 6 months, and I need someone to run my business, I need someone to pay my bills. To more traditionally, the way we use powers of attorney is if someone becomes ill and physically or incapacitated, or usually more typically mentally incapacitated. And by in writing giving a particular person called your agent the authority to make or handle certain financial aspects of your life, depending on what you own, you're giving them a lot of responsibility. Sometimes it's more than just paying bills. Sometimes it's getting mortgages on a real estate that you own, or selling property mm-hmm. that you own because it's time for you to move. Sometimes it's taking care of serious things like qualifying you for government assistance like Medicaid.
Okay.
So that's what a power of attorney does, and we've had power of attorney law for decades. And there's a form. Mm-hmm. And the form is created through our state legislature. And essentially, the form has been very much in the same format for at least since 1995. Mm-hmm. And that is that someone would be able to say, this is who I designate. Here's a series of checkoff boxes. You got to initial your name. You're called the principal when you're giving someone the power of attorney. Mm-hmm. And the principal would sign, and there would be a date, and you would sign it in front of a notary, usually the attorney, and off you would go. And if the person needed that to use that power of attorney, then it would be there when the person no longer had the mental or physical ability to manage their finances. What happened, though, is that we have, of course, good and bad, mm-hmm. mostly good. People take care of their parents. Hopefully they have a power of attorney. But what happened is that we also had situations where people didn't have maybe immediate family, maybe nieces or nephews, or children that they became estranged from. And the power of attorney, the agent, started misusing the funds. Mm-hmm. We also had scenarios where banks, families would go in with their power of attorney. The child says, knows the mom or dad is incapacitated now. They have received and remembered the instructions from their parents. They know where the parent keeps the document. They walk into a bank, and the bank says, oh, your parent did this 10 years ago. This is stale.
Oh, my word.
And the child is flabbergasted. What do? Because the banking industry decided that they got to make up the rules. So we had a couple of bad things going on.
Wow.
And so the legislature decided after a series of cases that they were going to make significant changes to the law. And so we now have those changes effective September 1. The other problem we had with powers of attorney before September 1 is since it was only a four-page document, a lot of people were lulled into the sense of a do-it-yourselfer. And you could walk into a stationery store, we used to call them five and dimes, and you can...
Remember those?
I don't think they exist anymore.
Me too.
And people would walk out with a blank document and try and fill it in themselves. Mm-hmm. And so we had problems with that as well.
Mom, do you have any questions for Beth so far?
My question is, if a document were signed and dated, say, 10 years previously,
mm-hmm.
okay, should that document be reviewed?
Okay, and that's really the first issue that we're dealing with. The law was effective September 1st, and a week before the law, my own parents, who did estate planning many years ago with a different attorney, my dad called me up and he said, so what do I have to do now? And I thought, well, if my dad doesn't know, then most of my clients don't know. So the answer to that is that what the law does is it changes dramatically. Not only the form, we are dealing with at least a 7 to 15 page document now.
Not likely a do-it-yourselfer.
Not a do-it-yourselfer at all. But what the law is very clear about is that if someone has a validly signed power of attorney that they executed 10 years ago, like you said, that they do not have to redo their power of attorney.
Okay.
And so, you know, what does that mean? Validly executed means that they signed it when they had mental ability, they signed it in front of a notary, and that the notary actually notarized it correctly.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Okay. That's it. But what it means also is that really the burden is on the consumer now, whether it's a senior or just a couple who's doing estate planning, who maybe did it several years ago. The burden is on you now. You've got to pull out your documents and you've got to look it over.
Because people know this, Beth? I mean, is it widely publicized?
You know what? We're trying to do it. The bar associations are trying to get the word out. But you have to pull out your document and you have to look at it and you have to say, does it still say what I want it?